stand before him, I was thinking today, when I stand before him, I hope God give us a life here. He blessed us. The Bible teaches us in the first two or three chapters of Genesis that God looked down and seen everything that he made. And after he acknowledged everything that he made, after everything, he said it was good. He said there in the first part of Genesis, he said, let us make man in our own image. And from the dust of the earth, he created man, and he was well pleased with man. And the only thing, the first thing that God saw upon the face of the earth that he did not like, and he said was not good. He said it was not good that man should be alone. The Bible said that God made him a helpmeet. He made Eve. Caused the sleep to fall upon Adam. And when Adam went to sleep, he took a rib from Adam and he formed the woman. And God was pleased with man and he was pleased with woman. But it went about 2,000 years, and God looked down upon the face of man, on the face of the earth, seen the heart of man, and the Bible said that the thoughts and the intents that God saw was continually evil. The Bible said that it repented God that he had made man. Going over into the New Testament, God don't do nothing by mistake, or God don't do nothing by accidents. God's got a reason and a purpose. Now some people think that God has got a bad side to where he causes bad things to happen, but the Bible teaches me, the way I study the Bible, that every good and perfect gift comes from the Father. We've got a warfare going on, and that's the enemy. This song talks about a woman. And the woman was used of man. The woman was despised of man. The Bible said there in John, he said that Jesus, being with his disciples, Gary must needs go through Samaria. Must needs. He had to go through Samaria. Samaria wasn't on the path, the common path. But there was a woman in Samaria that had a need. And the Bible said Jacob's well was there, and Jesus, therefore, being wearied with his journey, sat thus on the well. It was about the sixth hour, and there cometh a woman of Samaria to draw water. Jesus saith unto her, now listen, Gary, they had made plans. And their plans was to go into another city. But Jesus had to stop by Samaria. Are you glad that the Lord stopped by your way? Friend, I'll tell you what, he knows the need, the desires of our heart. Jesus told the woman, he said, give me to drink. For his disciples were going away into the city to buy meat. The woman saith unto her, the woman of Samaria saith unto him, how is it that thou, being a Jew, askest drink of me, which am a woman of Samaria? Isn't that one of the first lies the devil told us? We wasn't good enough for the Lord. Just like custom and tradition, Zach had taught this woman that Jesus wouldn't have nothing to do with her because she was of Samaria. Just like that song that talks to us, who am I? She had already been convinced that this Jew wasn't going to have nothing to do with the Samaritan. Jesus answered and saying to her, if thou knewest the gift of God, who is it that saith unto thee, give me to drink? Thou wouldest ask of him, and he would have given thee living water. The woman saith unto her, sir, thou hast nothing to draw with, and the well is deep from whence thou hast that living water. Art thou greater than our father Jacob, which gave us a well, drank thereof himself and his children, his cattle. Jesus answered and said unto her, whosoever drinketh of this water shall thirst again. Isn't that the same way, just like Ronnie was talking? We'll get something new. We'll get a new job. We'll get a new automobile. We'll get a new outfit. That'll satisfy us for a period of time. The Bible said over there in Exodus that, and he said over in Hebrews, and Moses recognized it in Exodus, that he chose rather to suffer the affliction of God's people than to enjoy the pleasures of sin for a season. This world will satisfy for a while.
Right. Come on.
He said, lady, if you drink of this water, you're going to thirst again. And he said, but whosoever drinketh of the water that I shall give him shall never thirst. The water that I shall give him shall be in him a well of water springing up into everlasting life. And what the woman say? Well, I'll think about it. She said, no, sir, give me the drink right now. That I thirst not, neither come hither to draw. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Like the woman at the well, I was seeking.
If the thing